The seeds of India's telecom revolution were sown when the Center for Development of Telematics was set up 25 years ago under the chairmanship of Sam Pitroda. He's joining us now to look back at what the telecom revolution achieved for India and what is the future. Thanks very much, sir, for joining us.
Now, thank you.
You know, it was quite a revolutionary idea to get somebody from outside the government space to set up something which was always been within various ministries. Now, but you created a completely new environment when you set up this department. What were the early days like?
See, first of all, in early 80s, 1981, I had an opportunity to meet with Prime Minister Indira Gandhi and give her a presentation on the role telecom could play in modernizing India. Then it used to take 15 years to get a telephone connection. All our systems were predominantly electromechanical. And the digital revolution had just started in the US. I had an opportunity to work on digital revolution in the US in early 60s. So as a result, I could convince Mrs. Gandhi that one, telecom is going to play an important role. It's a game changer potential. Two, we can do it on our own with focus on digitizing India's telecom network, using young Indian talent to build our own products and services, at the same time train human resource, and three, focus on access and rural communication and rural telephony as opposed to telephone density and urban focus. So to do these kinds of things, we really needed a bypass. It was not possible to do this within the existing telecom system.
Why was that?
Because the mindset then was electromechanical, go to multinationals to buy new products and services. No, we can't do it ourselves. It is too complicated. And it requires a lot of money to design. And most of the people in the telecom were not really trained for digital switching.
You put together a very enthusiastic and talented team as well. Now, was that a challenge? Was that one of the first challenges for you to get a good team together?
I think I was lucky, I would say, or we were lucky to have Mr. Mimamsi, who was from TRC and had a team. Then we had Dr. Pitke from TIFR. He had a core team of, you know, small group of 10, 15 people. So when we put these two core teams together, we really had the foundation. And based on that, then we went out and hired a lot of young people from IIT and other good universities, fresh out of college.
What was your pitch to these IIT graduates?
My pitch was that this is your opportunity to help build a nation. It is not about building telecom products. It is about really building a nation. And it requires a lot of hard work, sense of sacrifice, and you got to be in romance with a country.
Basically, you were asking them to give up dollar dreams and focus on India. Was it difficult for you
to
convince
them? No, I don't
think
it was difficult. I think young people were all charged up. They were really brighter than I thought. They were smarter than my generation was. And I thought they gave their best.
But it was also that you created an atmosphere from what we've heard and read, the open environment in which you allowed people to think and to create and to innovate. And sometimes a lot of people who work with you say that that atmosphere could not be replicated even in some of the bigger corporations they've joined.
I think 25 years ago, we were far ahead of our time in terms of not only technology, but also organizational structures and behaviors and all that. See, I, based on my own little experience, firmly believed that information and communication technology brings about openness, accessibility, connectivity, networking, democratization, decentralization. So if we were to build information technology products and services, we have to believe in these basic concepts. We can't be building telecom products and not believe in the value of telecom. So openness, accessibility, you could walk into my office anytime. Transparency. All of these were fundamental values.
But you had to shield them from government interference of legacy leaders.
Yeah, it was a little difficult, but I think overall, we got a lot of support from government, because essentially government was funding the whole project. So it was a government project.
Now, you know, 25 years later, you're again engaging with the government and you've been leading the National Knowledge Commission. But what I want to talk to you about is how technology, you know, in your vision, what is going to be the next new game changer for India? We have reached a certain level thanks in a large measure to the telecom revolution and telecom capabilities. What's the next big vision for India?
I think there are many hurdles or there are many challenges going forward. Telecom has essentially given us a great deal of confidence. We have created a large number of companies. We have 500 million telephones. We are adding 10, 15 million a month, month after month. We have huge software export industry.
And that BPOs road on the telecom
all that is part of the telecom platform. Now, the next challenge is to really focus on delivering development to the bottom of the pyramid.